So we moved into the hall in 2016. We thought we were prepared. Probably weren't that prepared. We got the keys on a Friday and then on the Saturday we moved in. So that was purely because who can pay rent and a mortgage in Auckland? Because it is such a big space, it can be difficult to make the rooms feel cosy and secure and homely. So we've always had that wow factor because it's so big, but to actually live in and to be comfortable in has been an interesting balance to find that. And I think we're still chasing it. Our latest layout, I think we might have clocked it. I'm a stickler for white. I paint everything white, which I know is really boring, but I just love it. And then I just felt like the entrance to the hall needed some personality. The whole hall is pretty interesting, but it was just blanket white. And I thought if there's ever a space to inject some personality and some life into it, it would be the entranceway. We chose a beautiful colour that's super matte. It's a Dulux paint from their Design Effects range. So it's called Chalk Effect and has a really matte finish, which I love. I'm not much of a shine girl. So chose this beautiful blue and went for it and I love it. So when we moved in, there was a room that had plumbing. It had a tiny little sink that you could fill water glasses. And then we put in a fabulous secondhand kitchen. And we've been living with that ever since. We actually got it off a family member who was renovating. So it came out of their house and into ours, which is really, I like that. I'm a big believer in buying secondhand and recycling and reusing wherever you can. I don't tend to have any boundaries with my DIY. I'm very happy to take on something I've never tried before. Like, you need something built, reupholstered? I'm your girl. The curved sofa, despite it looking more challenging, was actually not too bad. So I love a good DIY project. And I think I love things with a story. It's what makes it special. You know, you can buy really beautiful new things. And certainly if you have endless budget, you can buy really beautiful new things. But if you're trying to do things on a budget, I think the best way to get a beautiful result that has depth and has character is to get something that has had a story beforehand and maybe put your own twist on it that way. Yeah, we moved in and it was amazing. I don't think anything could have dampened our spirits. Not for a couple of months, and then it was like, oh, this is a lot of work. It was very much a haul at that stage. It had mummified rats in the cupboard and it was really filthy. It had about 100 years of grime built up in there, but we were so excited just to have a place to call our own. So we spent probably 6 months just bringing it back to a neutral state. Feels like we are in a perpetual state of renovation, but when I think about what we've done, most of it has been pretty surface level. But the thing that made the biggest difference was the paint job. About a year after we moved in, inside and out we painted, and that for me was a real milestone because it's gave it a breath of fresh air. It stopped it from an old crusty hall with cigarette stained walls, and it became our home. So that was a really big moment for me. A taxi driver recently said, I went to a wedding here 50 years ago, and that to me is why you preserve heritage, because they bring ties to the community that otherwise get lost. My favourite part of the hall is probably just that it's become our family home. So it's still a really interesting building with lots of character, but it's also our home, and I think that's a result of having this lovely girl in here and creating some family memories. The future of the hall is definitely somewhere we see ourselves being long term. It was always a family home for us and we hope to continue building our family, and watching Stevie grow up here will be really special. Hey, we have long hair like mummy one day maybe. Maybe have a little sibling for her one day. Yeah, we're excited. It's a family home for sure.